Yes. There you go. That's it. That's the end of the shitty summon. Let's wrap it up, boys. Come on. This summon feel is going to be a little bit different. Star God Liza is one of the most anticipated units in Grand Summoner's history. This is literally on the level of like your Emperors, your War God Fins, all that type of stuff. And she's finally releasing literally later tonight. And that pretty much means that everybody's going to summon for. If you're new, if you're older to the game, doesn't matter who you are, you're going to want to pick up Star God Liza. So in this should you summon, I'm not really going to be focusing so much on the banner per se, but I'm really going to be focusing on the absolute strengths of Star God Liza and tell you about some units that are currently in the game that you can pair up with Star God Liza to really get the most out of this unit, because this is a character I want to say that is not the same as War God Fin to an extent. Even though they are both extremely broken, they easily are going to be in the same tier as each other. War God Fin, I feel like, is more of a very upfront damage dealer while also being a supporter, while Star God Liza is a little bit heavily catered more so to that supporting role, just because she doesn't have any type of crit rate or anything like that in the kit, but she does have, you know, damage buffs, arch, and all that type of stuff. So she's gonna have a magic slot, of a support slot, and a 4-star magic or heal slot. If you guys watched the expert LB video, I told you guys that you may want to look into actually using your expert LBs on Liza, because you do unlock that 4-star heal with her skill sheet archgens for the entire team, which is amazing. This skill should stack with pretty much every single archgener in the game, apart from other units that use a skill to give an AoE archgen buff, like Rin for an example, Fitoria, characters like that. Her art reduces magic res is probably the most basic part of her entire kit. The true art is buffing up everybody's equipment CT by 60%. If I'm not mistaken, this is the largest equip CT buff in the entire game. Also buffs up all light allies damage by 150%, which of course benefits her and any other light unit on the team. The super art is a massive magic damage buff based on your current HP. It's pretty much similar to Ilya's super art, but this time it applies to the entire team, so a huge buff to everybody out there that loves using magic teams or magic characters. Now as for her passives, her main one that all you guys probably know about at this point is called Ether Recast. Every single one of your equips on Star God Liza specifically will have this new icon that will show a 1 and then a circle around it. Here's an example from the video showcase that they actually used. You see they press an equip and it goes on cooldown. Well, if you hold down on the equip, it will now use Ether Recast and it instantly resets the cooldown. You can only do this once per each equip though in a quest. But that's enough about just gushing over the kit. Let's actually talk about how to put it into practice. With Star God Liza, she's going to be a magic character, and if you really want to get a lot out of her, at least with what's currently on global, there's a few different characters you can run. One of the characters that I know a lot of people were actually like really excited for, especially in like your nuke teams and stuff, was actually using Demon Lord Rimuru alongside the Star God Liza. Demon Lord Rimuru will be able to benefit from Star God Liza's 300% magic damage buff and go absolutely insane when he pops off with his super art. Some other characters that are going to really enjoy Star God Liza's equipment CT buffs will be characters that are going to be very defense focused. So your Shiros, your Thetises, your Kirisames, all of them are going to adore this freaking character because they want to have their defense equips up as much as possible. The more uptime you have on your defense equips means that in harder content, the less likely it is that you freaking die. If that wasn't enough, this character is going to be extremely beneficial on pretty much any team you want to put her on, since she will somewhat function as another archgener. She works with every single unit in the game. And the thing about this unit is that she only gets better with time. And what do I mean by that? Well, Star God Liza is a character that really benefits from equipment. She benefits from equipment more than any other character in the game. Not only does she benefit from it, of course, she makes the equipment on your team so much better because she lowers the cooldown of all of them. So the better equips that you have and the more well-equipped you are for your team comps and everything means that Star God Liza just becomes exponentially better. If you are a brand new player and you get Star God Liza, you're going to think she's freaking terrible because you don't got any equips. You guys need to do your side story. You need to do some more events and, you know, maybe buy some stuff with rainbow gems. Use your equip tickets so you can select certain equips or whatever. Like, you're going to need a lot of stuff. I got to sneeze. Point is, you got to get your money up. All right, that's what I'm getting at here. Liza is going to usher in a whole new metagame to Grand Summoners Global. She's going to be insanely good pretty much forever. Not only is she just insanely future-proof, she's going to be really beneficial with a lot of other characters coming out. I know a lot of you guys really want that new Emperor, like BF Emperor. Yeah, she works fantastic with that guy, like insanely good with BF Emperor. Since BF Emperor can reduce his own equipment CT by half, and he also can buff up the equipment CT of specific type of equips, and that will stack with Star God Liza's 60% equip CT, so if you have all that stuff going, then it's just going to be even crazier. Not to mention, too, that Emperor is a light unit and his super art does magic damage, so he benefits from everything that Star God Liza is doing. Any magic damage dealer that's coming out, or just any character that's coming out that wants to use their equips, which heads up, every single unit in the game wants to use their equips, is going to be able to benefit from Star God Liza. So yeah, that's pretty much it. She's an insane character. I wish all you guys the best of luck. We're going to be having a summon video on this character tomorrow, so you guys can check the channel out for that. Hopefully, we walk away with her. And then, of course, we'll be having showcases and all that good stuff coming out probably Friday or Saturday. Either way, though, fam, that's going to be it for this video. Thank you all again for coming out. It's been your boy P. If you enjoyed this video, have me check out either one of the other videos popping on screen right now. Great content. Guarantee you'll love them. Like yesterday, we posted a Dokkan video. May want to check that out. It's a Dokkan summon video. Don't do too many different types of summon videos on the channel, but that one turned out really good, so check it out. But hey, that's going to be it for this one. Thank you all again for coming out, and last but not least, don't forget to drink water.